Hey guys, it's 9:22 on Sunday night. It is day 7 of my ultimate reset journey. Guys, sorry I'm late checking in, but the Olympics are on, and in case you didn't know, I spent like the first 12 years of my life being legitimately obsessed with women's gymnastics. So I was straight up convinced that I was going to the Olympics if I just did enough handstands, back bends, back walkovers, and round offs and cartwheels that I was headed there. So obviously that didn't happen, but that's okay. It was still one of my favorite passions growing up as a child. So I'm watching that right now. I'm on a commercial break. I'm tuning in here real quick to give you guys the skinny on how things are going with the Ultimate Reset on day 7. And then I'm headed back to watch some more. So first off, man, y'all, I made it through 1 week of this cleanse. I'm a third of the way done. I have to say I am actually super proud of myself for making it this far. When I bought this cleanse, and even when I started it, I honestly thought, hey, you're going to tackle this challenge and you're going to like fail really quick, because anything to do with food and me, I just have a really hard time when someone or a situation says, hey, you can't have that, then my brain goes into like this overdrive mode of, hey, that's all I want, right? So long way to say, I'm super proud of myself for making it this far in this cleanse. I'm excited for what happens in week 2. I'm excited for what happens in week 3. And wanted to share with you guys just a little bit about today and about my overall results so far. So number 1, today was a pretty good day. I opted again to have my Shakeology for breakfast because I have a standing beach date with my dog mom buddies. And there again, I didn't want to be out of the house and hungry. So Shakeology was the perfect answer to that. I just took it with me and took my supplements when I got to the beach. 30 minutes later, I had my shake, made it through the whole time and didn't get hungry. So that was a plus. Second thing, when I got back from the beach, we decided to go ahead and go to the grocery store and go, food prep shopping. Okay, so we loaded up, we went to the commissary and bought all of our groceries for the next week. Okay, that was challenging, right? I was already getting hungry before I left, so I actually did cheat on the plan a little bit today because I moved my afternoon snack of an apple up to the morning. So I took an apple, had that before I went to the commissary, so I didn't get hungry and cranky while we were at the grocery store. That's like the perfect storm, right? If you go to the grocery store hungry, you're just setting yourself up to either like fail or feel miserable. So I cheated there, came back home, had an enormous freaking lunch, guys. The cashew zucchini soup is huge. The mixed greens, microgreen salad is huge. It's ridiculous. So my lunch was crazy. I couldn't even finish it all. So I kind of stretched that out all throughout the afternoon. I had my soup first and then, there we are, we're back. About an hour and a half later, I had my salad. So I kind of ate just consistently throughout the day, which was fine. It worked out great. It kept my energy up and everything. Dinner was the second sort of like hiccup in the plan. And this is the first day that I've had any sort of bumps in the road, I would say. But we have Sunday night dinner with friends. And so I did pack my food. I took all my food with me. But what I did is I took my tempeh, right, which was the planned meal for night 7. So my baked tempeh, which was just great. I'd already prepared it earlier in the week. But instead of having the brown rice and the broccoli, which is on plan for that day, I used up some of the other additional portions of foods that I'd made earlier in the week. So from a convenience standpoint, it worked out great. I just don't really know how that mapped out to the exact nutrient profile that I was supposed to have today, but I still feel good. I still had, you know, tempeh as my base protein. Then I had my quinoa, cucumber, tomato salad leftovers. So that's, you know, carbs and veggies all in one. And then I had my leftover roasted root vegetables, which is more veggies. So I figure it's pretty close. It's not right on target, so I'll give myself a ding for that. But that's it, guys. I mean, it's going great. I'm feeling really good. I don't think you can tell in this light, really. But if you saw my first video that I posted before I started this cleanse, my skin was really awful. I mean, like, I still have some acne that you can see, but it's getting so much better. My skin is way smoother. It's clearing up, which is awesome. That's part of the reason I wanted to do this cleanse in the first place, is to see if what I'm eating had any impact on the hormones that were making my skin go crazy like a teenager. And so far, so good, guys. I don't have any makeup on, and I'm feeling very confident about my skin. So that's a win. Other things, I'm not really feeling like I'm losing any weight. Like, I don't feel any lighter, but I don't feel any heavier either. I'm not weighing until the end, so I won't know either way, but I feel good. So I'm not really worried about whatever the scale says or the inches lost, but just keep that in mind. You may or may not lose weight right away. I've been active in our support group, and a lot of people say that their weight fluctuates up and down in the first week especially, right? Because your body's trying to detox all that stuff. But anyway, guys, I just want to encourage you that if you are considering doing this, or you feel like you need a good system reboot, that you're just feeling off and you need to kind of start over from a nutrition standpoint, this is a great cleanse to do. I would not have been able to recommend it to someone before trying it myself. And now that I have at least started trying it, I feel very confident recommending that this is something that anybody can do. Yes, it's work. Yeah, it's a lot of planning. It's a lot of learning about food in a short amount of time, but it's worth it, man. You feel great. You feel really accomplished about what you're doing, and the physical effects just keep coming. So I'm extremely happy with how it's going so far and excited to see what happens in week 2 and 3. All right, y'all have a great night. I'm going to go back to watching my Olympics. Talk to you soon. Bye.